For people who are just tuning into the show, what is it all about?
It's about Mary, Queen of Scots, time in the French court. And it's about really the power struggles. We introduced Elizabeth I. So we have her whole court and their rivalry, which of course was an enormous one, brewing and percolating throughout the season.
How will the addition of this character affect yours?
Well, what's fun for me, there's a bit of a power play that I do between the two queens. I'm sort of hedging my bets in terms of who's going to have the most power and really what's going to benefit me and my country. That's been delicious. It's a lot of fun to play.
Now, this show is very interesting because there's strong female characters in a time where really it was a male-dominated world. And your character, Catherine, who's the Queen Mother of France, is truly a fiery force to be reckoned with in this show.
She's great. I love playing her.
What's your favorite part about playing her?
Her unpredictability is one thing, except for, and really that anything goes. She's someone who will survive. So she's very cagey, and she's very righteous. That's fun to play. And she's fiercely loyal. She's someone who is fiercely loyal to her family.
How long does it take when you come into work and it's time to get the garments on, get the hair done, makeup, and then get on set?
It takes a couple hours for sure because this is a wig. So I come in just a very different person. And sometimes, a lot of the times, people do not recognize me as myself outside of costume.
A wig's got to be kind of fun, though. You don't have to worry what your hair looks like when you come to work. I'm like, no,
there is a lot
wig.
Of benefit to that.
Because it's delicious fun. It's like dirty laundry. Glorious, gorgeous, dirty laundry.
That would be hilarious.
I want to see how that's going to work.
Okay, Sue.
It starts.
Here we go. Where do you start? Because we're standing with, you could use the word icon, legend.
Best friend I grew up with.
All
in my
of these
head.
Things. Meek and Follows. Oh my God.
Yay.
Oh my God. So anyway, now that that's out of the way.
Thank you.
But,
like, and you pronounced my name correctly, so you get a gold star.
Yes, gold star.
See?
Doesn't get much better than that.
We're
going
home now.
And you were, of course, nominated tonight for Rings.
I am.
Which, another period drama for you, basically,
yes.
I guess.
Well,
a little different for me.
Well, a little bit.
Yeah.
But how does that feel? I mean,
oh, I love it. I'm thrilled.
Yeah?
I'm thrilled.
These big costumes. And
they're beautiful costumes. Our designer, her name is Meredith Markworth Pollock, and her designs are incredible. It's pretty glorious to just, I mean, first of all, it's pretty great to wear a crown, let's be honest.
Oh, yeah.
But, like, you know, just from at home by yourself.
You know, you get to wear a lot of velvets and silks and just incredible fun. I mean, it's very amazing.
I'm just jealous thinking about that now.
Yeah.
No,
I
not
know.
Really.
No.
I couldn't pull it off.
You never know. Get the velvets.
You never know.
Yeah, maybe a nice velvet crush suit.
Yeah.
Maybe.
The men are wearing velvet too.
I know, right?
That's
for
right.
some reason, yeah.
Absolutely.
I think some to that.
Yeah.
But we've kind of asked this of everybody. Do you still get, like, excited and nervous on the carpet? Do you get excited for the awards?
Oh, absolutely.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because, you know, I mean, I would just say Megan Follows. What could possibly fluster you?
Oh, many things do, but you have to just celebrate. I'm thrilled.
Yeah.
I'm very happy. I'm very happy to be acknowledged for my work in Rain. I think Rain is an amazing show.
Very true.
I think it's an amazing show for women, our characters.
Yes.
We have three. I mean, we are very strong. I've worked with more women directors on Rain.
Oh, that's brilliant.
Than I have in my entire career.
Wow.
So there's also a tremendous support, and I've also been directing Rain, which has been really exciting. So.
Oh, very good.
Yeah.
Very nice. All right, that's more giddiness for me, actually.
Yeah.
I want to throw out the fact that I loved Hockey Night and getting to talk to you and Yannick on the same night.
He just came up and just hugged me because we haven't seen each other in a long time.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
I'm actually so flustered. So.
There you go.
I'll be fine.
Yeah, but I'm going to do it.
I'm never washing this cheek again.
My best friend,
you see?
And then we'll finish it up
with
a goofy selfie. If, there we go.
Megan, such a pleasure.
What a pleasure, too. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. It's good to meet you.
Congratulations. I got to say thank you so much for doing this interview. When you are part of something as prestigious as this, how does it feel getting a nomination? Because really, when I come to these nominations, I think of it always as Canadian entertainment history. And all of you are part of that.
Yeah, I like the way you think. That's good. That's good. I like it. I feel very proud. I'm working really hard, and I love that I'm acknowledged for it and to be a part of it and to see a lot of my colleagues and also to see new people. It's exciting to watch us keep growing as an industry.
I was going to say, the industry itself, how do you think it's changing, the Canadian industry, whether it be television or films? How do you think that is changing? Are we getting better?
I definitely think we're getting better, but and there's a lot of change, not just in this industry, I think in our industries in general, just because of our media platforms and how shows are being able to be made and how much more economically some of them can be made for. So the diversity of our programming, who can actually make shows, getting them seen. This is such a rapidly changing world. And I'm you know, coming from another time in a way, so I feel very grateful that I'm still getting to work and in this industry, in this world. But it is changing incredibly fast.
Talk a little bit about your role, please.
I play Catherine de' Medici on Rain. So I'm playing a powerful queen in the 1500s. And I love her. I love her. She's the bad guy sometimes. She's all kinds of things. She's good. She can be some people have certainly said she can be a bitch. She's fiercely loyal. She's very powerful. And I love playing her.
When this role was first brought to your attention, what were your thoughts? I mean, was it like you were just salivating going, oh man, I really get to sink my teeth into this?
I was. I mean, first of all, I was incredibly grateful. I'd been working in the theater a lot, doing work I was really proud of, working very hard. And I hadn't been involved in a television series for years and years and years. So it's amazing to be a part of something. We have now done 60 episodes of this show because we're coming to the end of our third season, and we do 22 episodes for the first two seasons, 18 this one. To be able to play something for a lot, long term, it's really very special because you really get to explore many facets of a character, and you got to be with her for a long time.
Any chance you think that this whole series can maybe? I see movie in some way, shape, or form. There's got to be something. What do you think?
Well, it's certainly a fantastic character the whole time, and it's a very dark time. It's a dark time politically. It's a time of real there are some murderous politics that are going on in this time, and who's on the right and who's on the wrong side of history. That is always a fascinating story.
I cannot wait. And before we go, what are the big plans for the night now? You got to be thinking, what am I going to wear? How am I going to be down there? And where's going to be the big party after everything?
That is true. You know what? Luckily, I have a little time to think about what I'm going to wear, so I'm not going to think about that right now, man, at all. I'm going to get myself really good coffee right now and something to eat and say hi to some of my friends here and acknowledge other people.
Well, just remember, there's a Tim Hortons around the corner, so you can always head down there.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much for the interview.
Thank you very much.